वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी अबाउट दी शेयर टेस्टिंग ऑफ माइल्ड स्टील। सो द बेसिक डिफरेंस बिटवीन दी टेंसाइल टेस्टिंग और कंप्रेशन टेस्टिंग एंड शेयर टेस्टिंग सर, इन टेंसाइल टेस्टिंग एंड कंप्रेशन टेस्टिंग वी आर गोइंग टू गिविंग द लोड इन ए मटेरियल विच इज पैरेलल टू द क्रैशेस ऑन द पर्टिकुलर मटेरियल। बट इन शेयर टेस्टिंग वी आर गिविंग द लोड ऑन द मटेरियल विच इज परपेंडिकुलर टू द क्रैशेस ऑफ द एनी मटेरियल। दट इज द बेसिक डिफरेंस बिटवीन दी शेयर लोडिंग एंड टेंसाइल एंड compression loadings. Okay, basically a stress value of the any metal is calculated based on the applied load per area, but we are going to give in the load on a two different planes so that the applied load is taken as a F2 divided by A, so that the double shear strength of the any metal is F2A. Okay, now we are going to testing the shear strength of the mild steel specimen. Before testing the shear strength of the mild steel specimen, you have to measure the diameter of that material so that we can get calculate in the area of the material. By using that area of material, we can calculate in the double shear strength of the material. Okay, in the apart use of that universal testing machine, this the same machine which is used for tensile testing and compression testing, as well as for the shear testing also, we are going to use the universal testing machine only. Then shear attachment, this is a particular attachment which is used to check. This is a shear attachment used to checking the shear strength of the any material and vernier caliper for the diameter measurement. First we are going to measure the diameter of the any specimen. We just check the diameter of the specimen by using vernier caliper. The calculated diameter is 6.04 millimeter. Then you have to place the mild steel specimen on the that particular shear setup, testing setup. You just place the shear testing setup. In this setup, by applying this metal piece, this particular metal piece, we can break the material. Okay. Yeah. Now we are going to apply the hydraulic loading by pressing this switch. By pressing this switch, a hydraulic loading is applied on this rod, which is going to test it. Just place it. Now we are loading is applied so that the rod is breaking. The failure load of this particular mild steel specimen is 1600 kilogram. Okay, again we are going to take in the values. Double shear strength value is calculated by using the formula. We can easily calculate the area of the cross section area of that particular specimen by using the formula, by using the diameter and this formula. We can take the failure load by using through the universal testing machine so that we can easily calculate the double shear strength of the material. Likewise, once again we are going to measure the second specimen's diameter and we are going to insert the specimen to the shear setup. Again we are going to apply the loading. Due to that hydraulic loading, once again the material is broken. The failure load of the material is 1700 kilogram. Now the calculated double shear strength of the material is 289.23. Once again we have to take the third specimen and once again measure the diameter. Going to insert into the shear setup. I'm going to apply the load. Now we are due to the hydraulic load, metal is breaking. The failure load is 1050 kilogram. Yeah, the calculated the double shear strength is 195.01. Okay, this is what the average double shear strength of the material, that is 2.75 newton per millimeter square. This is a calculated average double shear strength of this metal specimen. Thank you.